Retail arbitrage is the process of finding price gaps and taking that money. If you want to make 80 bucks an hour, 500 bucks a week, really it's just limited by how much you want to work, this video is for you. It's about retail arbitrage at Walmart and what they really don't want us to know. Remember those price gaps I was talking about? Well, that is exhibited right here. Equate brand Pepsi Day C, for all intents and purposes, is cheaper than the Pepsi Day C brand. They're both the same medicine, they both provide the same relief, but the Equate brand, Walmart's brand, is much cheaper. We're gonna be targeting in on these products today. Now the issue is with products like this, like heartburn medicine, like laxatives, like any of this stuff, is that Walmart is constantly changing the UPC codes and other details about these products to help combat retail arbitrage. When you sell these on Amazon, the bottle in your hand has to match everything in the listing. And if the pill shape changes, if the amount of active ingredients change, then that is no longer a viable way to sell it. So what does Walmart do when you begin making money off of them? They change the rules, but don't worry, we're gonna find ways around that. These fruit smiles right here are selling for almost 30 bucks on Amazon. There is a caveat though, they're gonna melt. So when these ship, you have to ship them with ice packs in the box. If you're willing to do that, you can turn $4, $7, whatever they cost, into 30 bucks on Amazon, minus shipping, minus fees. It's still gonna be profitable. If you don't wanna mess with heavy products, light products, lightweight products are the way to go. These Fruit Punch drink mix pouches are so light. Over here, these are caffeine included energy packs. And these, I scanned a bunch of them, they are good. I've noticed that whenever there's some sort of special branding or special fruit like dragon fruit or passion fruit or any of that fun stuff, generally it's gonna charge for more. Both because they are a limited amount in the stores because they're not a normal, you know, in quotes, flavor, and also because the people who like these fruits, like dragon fruit, this is delicious, I bought one for myself, they're willing to pay a bit more. These were very cheap. You can see on the screen they're going for a profit. It isn't a huge profit, but in terms of ROI, if you can do this every single day, the money's gonna add up. It just is, you know, making 35% return on your investment is not a lot for a $4 purchase, but $4 times 100, suddenly you're making some decent money. But I don't want you to think that only Equate products our retail arbitrage options. Now this box is screwed up. This one beat it with a baseball bat. But the ones that aren't abused by who knows who, what malicious stalker did this, we can still sell those. Cheetos, mac and cheese, bold, and a cheesy. The other two flavors, the flaming hot, the jalapeno, small profit, but these for 96 cents at Walmart, I'm in Michigan, no tax on food, these are selling for over $1 profit, and that's competing against Amazon. How crazy is that? You can sell it with the big boys, buying from Walmart, and still make money. You're probably saying, Blake, why didn't you buy all of them? Well, that's because these videos are about validating ideas. That's why I do this. I'm not trying to say, hey, buy everything I buy. I'm saying, look at my processes, imitate those. Here are results you can expect. The final thing is sunscreen. So if you know about Amazon, you know that sunscreen is a topical, that's a gated category. You know that grocery is a gated category. How do we get beyond that? Because the more gates there are, the more restrictions there are, generally the more profitable, or at least the more opportunity for profit there is. And that's where katytexaswholesale.com comes into play. You can buy topical lotions from them, get ungated in the category, and then sell Equate brand like this 50 SPF sport sunscreen on Amazon. People love sunscreen, you use it all the time, it's a great flip, it's highly seasonal, so even consider buying out of stock stuff, discontinued stuff, and selling it that way. All right, so as you can see, we got a handful of stuff, spent about 10 minutes in there. Okay, we're back in the warehouse, and I wanted to show you how my shipment's going. It's not done, I have a whole bunch of other stuff, but just the things that we bought at Walmart. Here they are. So the things that are in two packs, I wrapped up. This is a four pack, it's wrapped up. And I have the FBA stickers
on there. And if you want to see how to do this, just stop by a Wednesday live stream on my channel, and I'll go over it with you. I have some tutorials on my channel, but they're kind of hard to find because not a lot of people are looking up like such niche stuff, but I can talk you through it. So we have our FBA labels. I use a program called Inventory Lab, but you can just use Amazon to do this and it doesn't cost any money. And when I say that, I'm talking about like, yeah, this costs money. I have to ship this, but Inventory Lab costs like $50 a month. And Amazon, you can get these labels for free, basically. A little bit different process, but it's not going to cost you. The lotion has to go in a bag with the top taped down because it's not sealed on the interior. That's fine. And then the one thing I'm kind of worried about is these laxatives. So the label fits right there. It might be too small. I don't remember the exact rules. I think it's long enough because the label fits on there, but if not, I might have to pay a 49 or 50 cent reboxing fee. And again, not a big deal. I've sold all these things before. I haven't had fees before, but just because it hasn't happened to me yet doesn't mean it might not happen in the future.
It really is that simple. You go to a Walmart, you scan the barcodes on the products, it pops up the Amazon listing. You can use the eBay app even. If you've seen my other videos, you know this process works at Walmart, at Dollar Tree, at Lowe's, at Home Depot, at really any retail store, because these retail stores are not as agile as you. They cannot adjust their prices the same way an individual can to adapt to market conditions. If you want to compete against these giant monopolistic corporations, you can't do it on price. You have to do it on service. You have to do it on understanding the market. Now, here are some frequently asked questions. One, is this legal? Yes, it is legal. It is fine to resell Walmart stuff. Two, is it hard to get started on Amazon? I think it is kind of tricky. You know, you should probably start off with something like used books before you graduate to retail arbitrage. Used books can be cheap. This can be kind of expensive. And it's hard to screw up selling a used book. And the third question is, how do I get ungated to sell grocery, to sell topicals, to sell over-the-counter medicine? How do I do that, Blake? Well, I'm going to tell you. You're going to go get invoiced orders from distributors, and I just so happen to have a 10% off code for katytexaswholesale.com. They are an e-commerce-oriented distributor. They're not going to have the dirt-cheap Walmart prices, but they are going to send you invoiced orders. So you go there, you order 10 Burt's Bees lotion sticks, and then you get ungated in both Burt's Bees, the brand, and topicals. You can then begin your retail arbitrage journey with the invoices received from katytexaswholesale.com. I hope this video was helpful. Please remember, give it a big thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll see you guys later.